Make me swear, make me harder, make me lose my breath, make me water, make me swear, make me harder, make me lose my breath, make me water.
Normally, I could keep my cool, but tonight I'm whining. I'ma be in a dangerous mood, can you match my timing? Telling me that you really want it, what you're hiding. Talk is cheap, so show me that you understand. I like it. Can you blow my mind? Set off my whole body. If I give you my time, can you snatch my soul from it?
Hello, hello, hello. Happy Friday, everyone. Mm-hmm. Welcome to Miscommunication Talk Podcast. I am your host, Queen Gemini, and I am with
DJLAB. I thought you were going to introduce me. What happened to the introduction?
I was about to. Man, you came in. You came in too soon.
I'm surprised. I'm sorry. Okay.
I was going to blow you up. Let's start over.
Okay. Go. All right.
But he didn't mess it up.
Shit. Well, fuck it then. Okay. All right. Well, we here. Miss Gemini in the building, of course. What's going on, lady?
Nothing. How was your holiday?
It was good. I can't complain. Didn't do anything, which is exactly what I wanted to do. Nothing.
Ditto. I didn't either.
You ain't do anything?
I went to a couple of people's houses, but...
Well, you know, you say this is a hard time for you, so, you know, I get that. I understand.
Yeah.
Trust me, I understand.
So I just, you know, I got invited to a few places, so I just went and, you know, just hung with them and their family and stuff like that.
Oh, okay. Well,
so,
you had to, you know, cook it, right?
No, I cooked on Saturday. I actually cooked my Thanksgiving Saturday. So, yeah, I didn't actually want to cook on that day, so.
So you cook Saturday, okay.
Yeah,
so your
hello
family
to
didn't
all,
have something to eat, it was just Saturday.
Yeah, hello to all my Facebook, Instagram, and TikTok friends.
What's up, Facebook, Instagram, TikTok
friends? Yeah, because everybody's okay. Saying hi, and I'm like, okay.
Yeah, but, what's going on?
Nothing. We got a... You know, the blog's been real, real hot lately. They've been off the charts lately. So
every day is something new, right?
Every day is something
new.
Every day is something new.
That's better for us.
Every day we live in truly humble under God.
Every day we thugs.
Right. Every day we live in truly humble under God.
We thugs around here. What y'all talking about? Right.
I can't believe he said that, but okay.
Hey, he came up with it, though. You got to give him...
I mean, he thought about it.
You got to give him credit for what he came up with, right?
He thought about it. It was real clever. Real clever. He thought he had enough time to think about it. He'd been in jail since forever.
Right. So he came up with a good one.
Yeah, he thought about it. He had enough time.
Who are we to say that that's not true, though? Who are we to say that that's not the case?
I'm not no one to judge. So, I mean, if that's what you feel like your name should be, that's what your name should be. Hey, we going to roll with it.
We all are truly humble under God, right?
We going to roll with it. If that's what you say your name is, we rolling with it.
We all thugs.
So, I'm going to walk around and say, I'm a thug. I'm truly humble under God.
Right.
So
get with the program.
So, yeah.
So, what else we got going on?
We going to talk about. I'm gonna start with the juicy stuff first, and then
all of it's juicy, though.
Yeah, all of it's juicy, but we're gonna go into Jenny, Mai, and Jeezy because they the least.
Okay.
We need to be talking about.
Okay.
I really don't even care about them.
Jenny, Mai, and Jeezy. Okay.
So yeah, Jenny Mai is allegedly going after Jeezy because allegedly he cheated on her during their marriage.
Okay.
So in their prenup, it stated that if he cheats, he has to pay up.
Oh, okay.
This came out today, so she is going after him for the ducats.
So she wants them dollars.
She wants some money.
Well, I wish I had the song queue up. Where them dollars at?
Right. She definitely wants money. She wants money. So,
I like Jeezy. He all right. You know, I'm not really a big fan of all his music, but I don't know. He might have done that allegedly.
I don't know. It seemed like he had changed. I feel like he was changing for the better. He was real quiet lately. You know, he had been quiet when he was with her. You know, he seemed...
You're not gonna tell on yourself.
He seemed real in a Chinese, Asian, persuasion, Caucasian land.
Well,
so
he had you fooled then.
I mean, yeah. I mean, we ain't hear no thug rap lyrics. None of that.
We ain't hear no rap lyrics.
He was eating, Chinese food and rice and stuff. So, I mean,
wrong for that. He was eating what?
Chinese food and, stuff like that with chopsticks and stuff.
I ain't even got my pistol ready yet. I ain't got my pistol cocked.
He was cool. He was laying low. He was laying low for a while.
He was immersed in Asian culture.
In the Asian persuasion.
He was taking his shoes off at the door and everything.
Yeah,
huh?
He was leaning at, bowing at the table and all that.
Oh,
so,
shit.
He was living life. So
Oh wow.
We ain't gonna say.
That might be a little racist.
I'm not racist by any means, but hey, we didn't see Jeezy for a long time. Now don't get me wrong, we hadn't seen him for a while. Then all of a sudden, boom, here he is with her.
The music got us cut off over here on Instagram. Can't believe that. Instagram, man, what the hell? I'm finna say, y'all gonna just have to cut me up. You can literally show someone getting killed on Instagram and they will not block it. But your ass play some music.
They gonna block it.
Like,
ain't your music.
Jesus Christ, Instagram, pick your priorities, man. Like, you can see somebody getting beat up, ran over by cars. I just shot a video of somebody getting shot up by two M16s and they Tahoe truck. Fine. Soon as I play a 2 second bit of music, the video gets blocked.
And it probably had like 200 views, too. Two million views.
That shit sucks ass. Like, real deal. That shit sucks ass. It is depressing. Anyway.
Yeah, we ain't gonna let that that bother us. But, yeah. But we gonna move on to Rod Wave.
Uh-huh.
he is being sued by Boosie and a few other people for stealing music lyrics.
So they actually are suing him.
They're allegedly suing him.
I wish I could find. Let me see. Where did you find the music at? I can play it. I don't know. Instagram might block it.
Jesus Christ. Facebook and on Facebook.
I was gonna play it, but.
Yeah, Rodway, I don't know what's going on, honey, and what you going through in this lifetime, but yeah, stealing music lyrics ain't what's up.
And you play some lyrics. Now, I'm not a Boosie fan.
I'm not either.
I can't stand him.
I agree. His
voice rapping sounds like nails on the fucking chalkboard to me. But when you play his rap and play Lil Rodway's rap,
it sounded exactly identical.
So Boosie has a case allegedly, but it sounded identical. Like, I was like, Jesus Christ.
My thing is the stealing the lyrics of Mary Mary. Now, honey, I get it. I mean, everybody love a good gospel song every now and then, but stealing the whole song? Come on now, honey. What is you doing? Who is your writers?
Right. Nobody. Mary Mary, Boosie. And then they say he stole Jay-Z too?
Yeah, Jay-Z allegedly and some other rap artists. So, I mean, come on, Rodway. Do better.
Oh, I just happened to pop up on Instagram. We ain't going to go into it, but on West Side Mistress page, they put that Tiana Taylor accuses ex Iman Shepherd of leaving her and their kids in under construction home while he lives in a fully renovated pad. Mm. I thought they never get broke up.
I didn't either. That was relationship goals to me.
Cause she freaky than a motherfucker. Like, how you get over that?
But I think she like women, allegedly.
So?
I think she like women.
So?
I don't know.
She could break. I'll watch her and another woman do it. Then I do it too.
We gonna dig in some more into their relationship.
Next week we gonna dig into
Tiana Taylor and Iman Shumpert.
On West Side Misfits. So I just thought I'd mention it because I was like, whoa.
Now let's talk about T.I. and his son King, cause King been off the chain. King been off the chain.
Right.
So we're gonna talk about King. First of all, how you feel about King?
Well, I believe that allegedly, I believe that they, like we talked about the other day, I believe he ain't just started this. He has not just started this.
He's been always doing this.
Like, he's always.
And we just really seeing the real him.
Off the chain. Like, you think about all this back in all the shows when they had the reality show.
Mm-hmm.
And how King was always a little wild. Remember, mm-hmm. Think about it. Like, this is documented stuff. Like, I had to think about it after yesterday's show. I had to think about it. But he always been acting like that.
I think with King, you know, T.I. tries to spread his love throughout all of his children.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like King wants T.I. to just focus on him and only him. And because, they trying to block my Facebook.
For the music.
Yeah, and because T.I. is not showing him the 100% A1 attention that he's seeking for,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
It's, oh, y'all never did anything for me, or y'all never was there for me. Y'all sent me to my grandmama house and all of this. Because King been asking to rap for a long time.
Right.
But as we watched the movie of T, or the show of T.I. and King and all of that and stuff like that growing up, he spread his love throughout all his kids. Not just King, all of them.
Right.
Whenever all of them show interest, T.I. was always there to support all of them.
Right.
But I think King just want that focus, and he want to be in the position that his daddy in. But, like Steve Harvey made a point a long time ago. We can't even talk about Steve Harvey and his ratchet-ass kids. But, like Steve Harvey made a point a long time ago, you got to crawl before you walk.
Right.
You can't just get – I can't just because I'm your celebrity dad, mm-hmm. I can't just say here. And put you out there into the world. You gotta make a name for your own self.
But a lot of doors that probably would not have been open to him were open to him because of who his parents are.
Exactly, but
even Steve Harvey say that he could say that, but I'm quite sure we're not talking about Lori Harvey because she's a great, like, because she's a regular person. Like, people wouldn't be talking about who you dating if wouldn't be talking about who she's dating if it wasn't for the fact that she's Steve Harvey's daughter. So he can make that claim.
And that's not even his real daughter.
Right, okay. He can make that claim and say, you got to make it on your own, blah, blah, blah. But a lot of doors are open because of who these kids' parents are.
Right.
They become celebrities because of the... They didn't have to do anything. But because they have that last name and that parent, those things happen.
Yeah. But I think King should just pipe down a little bit, stop smoking weed, and get his mind together because... You know, he's doing a little bit too much lately. He's doing a little bit too much.
Like, well, he makes his own money.
He makes his own money, true enough, but all this attention seeking is a little bit too much. And them teeth that you got in your mouth, whoever your fucking dentist is, please go back and get that shit redone because...
But he paid for them himself. Like, what? I mean...
Yeah, Instagram blocked me.
He did. They did. For what?
I have no idea.
We ain't had no music playing.
Yeah.
Just started over.
But yeah, he just...
Don't let it throw you off. Start it over.
No, I'm good. He just doing a little bit too much. So right. I just think he just need to pipe down. And he'll get there eventually. I seen this Instagram post where he said, for $10,000, I do all the interviews y'all want. Mm-hmm. $10,000 interview. Now you doing it for money.
Right.
Now you doing it for publicity.
Right.
So, I don't know. But anyway... Yeah, that's that. And I seen T.I. go off last night. Was it two nights? Well, Sunday. Well, I think whatever it was. It was a few days ago.
Uh-huh.
Went off on the club promoters.
Yeah, I saw that too. Where he went to the club, told him, y'all gonna put my picture, me and mine's. Y'all right. Don't get nothing. Give me everything.
Mm-hmm. I guess they didn't pay him all of his money.
No, I think they didn't pay him at all. They just put his face
on the flyer.
And him and his Tim and Kenny's face on the flyer.
They do that to everybody. They right. Do that to
that's,
everybody.
That's what they did. They just put their face on the flyer. And I don't know if they said that they were going to be there or what.
They allegedly said they were going to be in the building.
Oh, yeah. And he ain't know nothing about it.
Mm-mm.
Yeah, you can't do that, especially in Atlanta.
Yeah.
I mean, how do you know word
the niggas
word,
stay right know? Around the corner. he liable to pop up like
right,
he did.
Right,
he
right.
Stay right around the corner, so... Right.
You got to expect that. You got to expect that that's going to happen in the city of Atlanta where everybody knows him.
Right.
Born and raised in Atlanta. You're going to try to put his face on the flyer in the city that he was born and raised in.
And don't think he's going to show up.
And he a celebrity. Come on, man.
Show up for real, because y'all put this man's name on the flyer.
Yeah. Talk about he going to be there. Come on. Get it right. Get tight.
Said he going to pass out. They was going to pass out free beers. He said ain't nobody getting no beers, no nothing. And he's standing on business. He's standing on business.
He learned. He took a pay.
He's standing on business.
From his son, but look, he's standing on business. I get it. Standing I don't blame him, though. I think he should have.
Yeah. He did. He definitely went off.
Right.
He definitely.
I think he did the right thing. I ain't going to lie.
Yeah, he definitely. How do you feel about all the alleged sexual assault people that are being charged and coming out? That's been, it's a lot.
It's a lot.
Diddy and Cassie done set the flames, and now everybody done been molested.
Him giving up
allegedly.
That $30 million so quickly just opened floodgates.
It was $30 million? I don't know how much.
Somebody said it was $50
million. They never disclosed the amount, I thought.
Somebody said it was $50 million. I don't know exactly how much it was. Allegedly, it was $50 million. Allegedly, it was $30 million. But just the fact that they settled so quickly.
Yeah.
When I think all these new charges that's coming out are civil cases, aren't they? They're not criminal because the statutes have ran out on some of them, right?
Yeah, it's been years.
So I think a lot of them are civil, so a lot of them are for money.
Yeah, of course.
I mean,
Like,
to each his own,
all
right?
The Bill Cosby women that came out, like...
Yeah.
Y'all old as dirt. Y'all old as all dirt.
They still need justice.
I mean, yeah, I get
the
that. I get that. And like somebody
need.
Said, say something when it happened. Don't say something 50 years later.
Well, he was a celebrity.
He's a celebrity now.
And you know, I was scared. You know, it's always that.
He's a celebrity now. What always. They didn't have them, what you call them things where you can't talk, them
NDAs.
They didn't have them NDAs like that back then.
No, they didn't.
So why you didn't say something back then?
They definitely didn't have NDAs back then. It was a wild time in them 70s.
Right, so.
What, 60s, 70s, and 80s?
Yeah, like.
90s. But you know, did you see Did you see Cameron snitching ass?
No, I didn't see
Cameron. On a podcast with him and what's his name? Mace?
No, I didn't see Cameron.
And he told a story about him and Mace. Mm. Gang banging a girl. He like went into it. Like,
oh, I have to go in.
Yeah, we'll
have to go look and at look that. And talk, up. We'll talk about that later.
I felt like he might have told on themselves the way he was describing it.
That's probably why Mace hurried up and became a pastor. He was going to get in trouble. He knew his time was coming.
But he went back and told it. He told the story about the 90s, and that was the story he chose.
I am so waiting for Farnsworth Bentley. I'm going to keep saying this. I am so waiting for him.
That man in the church, he ain't studying, y'all.
No, I seen him on a few videos. But I am so waiting for him to tell his story. I want to know what happened.
I don't think nothing happened.
Something happened.
You think something happened?
Something happened. Because how do you just stop communicating with a person? Like, y'all just completely cut all conversation. Like,
Do we know that, or did he say,
we see you and one minute we don't?
I mean, do we know he just cut it off like that, or did he say to Diddy, "Hey man, I'm finna get in the church. I can't be doing all this stuff we be doing, and still give myself to the Lord." So I'm happy.
That don't mean
we'll know what they said behind private.
That don't mean they still can't hang, because allegedly Diddy had gave himself to God, and that's when he became Brother Love and all of this.
But that was years later.
I'm waiting. Farnsworth Bentley, I know you probably will never see this podcast, but I hope you do. But if you are out there, please tell us your story, because I want to know.
Give it to the Lord.
I want to know. I want to know what happened.
Give it to the Lord. And let's see what happens.
I want to know, because I know something happened. I don't know.
I think we searching on that. I don't believe it. I'm going to say I don't believe anything
if
happened.
If they do a surviving Diddy document,
oh my God,
I guarantee
Let it go.
I guarantee you he going to be on there. I guarantee you he going to be on there.
I don't think they going to do a surviving Diddy. Jeez.
I hope they do one.
We're going all the way to surviving Diddy?
Yes, I want them to survive Diddy document. Oh, I want to see it. I want to see it.
Okay. I want to see it. So say she want to see it.
Yes, I'm going to be
front. You going to be there with popcorn?
I'm not going to go to school that night. If it's on a Friday, we ain't doing no podcast. If it's on a Sunday, I'm not going to church. We going to be watching Surviving Diddy, because I want to see it.
Oh.
I want to see it. And I know it's going to be good. I know it's going to be way better than R. Kelly document. So I want to see it.
Oh, wow.
I definitely want to see it.
Allegedly, it's going to be better.
We know it's going to be better.
Okay, what else?
Especially if they going to have Day 26 come on there and talk about how he made them walk to go get that pie. They going to have everybody.
Allegedly, this all allegedly. We don't know for sure until the documentary come out.
They going to have Aubrey O'Day, because you know she is
at his throat.
She at his throat. Yes, come on, please. Producers, writers, come on, somebody.
Is Miami going to say some stuff, too?
She too in love. She liked the mess. She liked the drama.
Okay.
She liked the drama, but I'm pretty sure they're going to have Albie Shore on there.
Oh, yeah.
They're going to have J-Lo, all of them. I want all of them on there. Yes.
Oh, shoot.
Yes, please, if y'all is listening, please do this documentary, because I want to see it.
I don't think J-Lo going to be on there. I don't think J-Lo going to be on there.
Because she probably got her own dirt.
Right.
She probably got
allegedly.
Her own dirt.
Allegedly.
Yeah, she probably, all of men, she be banging.
Allegedly.
Probably got her own dirt. Her dirt probably go neck and neck with Diddy dirt.
Oh,
so.
Lord.
Yeah, nah, she probably will be on there. She probably won't. He was a great guy when we were dating. And, you know, I just had the best time of my life.
Right.
It just didn't work. Yeah.
Because she didn't want her dirt to come out.
Right.
Okay.
Right. Because then her men allegedly going to come out and be like, well, J-Lo, you know, she paid me for this and that. Yeah.
She like fucking niggas with bottles.
Right.
Allegedly.
Right. Yeah. Okay. So, yeah.
Okay.
But, yeah, we I want to see that.
Okay, you excited too?
I am, and I feel it's gonna come.
You're a little bit too excited. I
feel it in my soul that in 2024 they not gonna disappoint us. I feel
you're a little bit too excited, like really.
Now,
like,
now that the writer's strike is over, I feel like it's brewing.
Okay, we're gonna see what happens.
Yeah, but back to the people that's allegedly being accused of sexual assault. We have Steven Tyler. I don't know that guy.
Because he's with Aerosmith.
We have Jamie Foxx. Now y'all going to lay off Jamie now. Yeah. I love me some Jamie.
You love Jamie?
Yeah, y'all not going to do Jamie like that. Y'all pick anybody else. But y'all can pick Boosie if y'all want to. Pick anybody else.
Put Boosie in Jamie Foxx's place.
But y'all going to lay off Jamie.
Okay.
It's certain people that I defend. Now, Jamie, like you was defending the flute guy.
Oh.
Y'all going to lay off.
Hold on. One thing we not going to do, we not going to circle back around to Andre 3000.
Everybody else been in the block.
We not circling back because he is the number one album.
What?
He has beat out all the rappers with his release. I'm telling you, he going to get the best album of the year.
Whatever. But
in the rap category.
Y'all going to lay off Jamie. Jamie ain't did no such thing.
Okay.
Jamie just looked at y'all and kept it moving.
Okay.
We got Russell Brand.
Uh-huh.
And Axl Rose. I don't know. None of
Guns N' Roses.
And it's a list of other people that's allegedly on this list.
But you know those rock groups back in the 80s, they was...
Oh, yeah, they was wild as ever.
They got some stories to tell.
They was wild as ever. And I believe it.
It was a documentary I saw about back in the 80s and rock groups, and yeah. I was like, wow.
Yeah, I believe it. When the drugs and the alcohol came into play.
Involved.
Yeah, I believe it.
I was one rock guy, I forget his name, he said those back rooms were just debauchery.
Yeah, I believe it. I definitely believe that it used to go down in the 70s and 80s with them rock groups. I believe
especially
it.
Especially in the 80s.
Yeah, I believe
especially
it.
Especially in the 80s. Like 83, 84, 85, it was like Freaknik for the rock groups.
Mm-hmm. I believe it, yep. Well, they used to have Guns N' Roses concerts and all of that. It was some other concerts that was going on, so I definitely believe it went down big time. I definitely do.
Not in the DM, in the green room.
She said, what they said? Them people had to.
Had to or had whoa?
I can't see it. But yeah, I believe it.
Hmm.
Yep, so I had did some little digging.
Okay.
And I was digging.
You went down a rabbit hole.
I was digging.
Okay.
And some of these celebrities is some thoughts.
Allegedly they are. What they do?
They some thoughts. They any and everything.
Wow. A lot.
They dating history is bananas.
Yeah, you went down a rabbit hole because who would think of that? Look up their dating history.
But we had talked about we was going to pull up a few people dating history. We talked about this a few weeks ago. People had...
So they say those people back in the 80s had women in lines waiting to give them free sex. That's true.
I believe that. I do.
That back room used to be lined up.
And that's how R. Kelly got set up, because them chicks used to wait. I actually attended a R. Kelly concert when I was younger.
Okay.
Because this guy, I ain't going to call him no BD, none of that.
What's a BD?
He think he a baby daddy, but he not. He just signed a birth certificate.
Shit.
But,
let's not look up your history.
The guy that signed my oldest birth certificate.
Okay.
He used to work for a radio station. He took me to an R. Kelly concert.
Okay.
And them chicks was wild. They were wild.
Yeah.
Like, I'm talking about all in the VIP half naked wild.
Yeah.
So I believe they stood in lines to have sex with them people. And I believe some of them women that is accusing R. Kelly of what he allegedly supposed to have did ain't innocent.
Sure, we had one of the comedians come in and tell a story because her being from Chicago, how she used to, they be waiting for R. Kelly.
Yeah.
Go to his house and everything.
Yes, yes.
And she said she was younger.
Yes. I ain't going to tell y'all a story that I experienced firsthand, but not with R. Kelly, but with another famous celebrity person. Singer.
Right.
We ain't gonna dig up my history because it's not about me.
Well, don't say no name. Just leave it about. Leave it like it.
But he's still relevant to this day.
Okay.
But how me and my friends went back to their hotel room, and we're gonna leave it at that.
Okay.
Just let's say it was wild in there.
They were buck wilding in there,
and I felt uncomfortable.
Wow.
So.
Oh, okay.
But yeah, I believe. Yeah.
Oh, it goes down.
Yeah, of course. It still do.
It still goes down.
It still do.
It might get tamped down some now with all these lawsuits.
No, because this new generation of women, they outrageous.
But they got phones now. They can record it now.
Yeah, they definitely probably recording. But like I said, they got a lot of them NDRs now. So a lot of them say you can't record or you can't bring your phone around and stuff like that. So, you know.
They say Jay-Z and Beyonce got one. You want to hang out with them?
Yeah.
You got to sign that NDA.
Yeah, when I was watching that documentary with Kirk Franklin, his people had to sign one to even be around him.
Right.
So, it's still around. So, now it's like, you ain't recording nothing. It's just your word against mine. Mm. So, and only way a lot of these celebrities get caught up now is because a lot of these celebrities be sliding in DMs and people be screenshotting.
All day, every day.
Sliding in DMs and text messages.
You got to be more stealth than that nowadays. Mm-hmm. You can't have your real name on the DM.
Right.
You got to have a fake name and give them a backdoor password or something so they can know it's really you. Like,
yeah. Like, yeah, y'all some idiots. But anyway, back to what I was saying. But yeah, I was digging. The relationships I pulled up is outrageous.
Okay.
Outrageous. We're going to start with
our start with one. Let's get into it.
We're going to start with our girl, Lori Harvey.
Okay.
This girl overlaps her relationships. she wastes no time being single.
Okay.
She definitely overlapped. I only wrote down, I ain't write down everybody's years and dates, but I wrote down hers.
Okay.
Because the overlapness is ridiculous.
Okay.
So, she dated some guy named Memphis Depay. I don't know him.
I don't know who that is.
She dated him in 2026 to 2018.
Okay.
Then 2018, she dated Justin Combs for a brief moment.
She dated him from when now?
2016 to 2018.
Okay.
And then she dated Justin Combs in 2018.
Okay.
Then she dated Trey Songz from 2018 to 2019.
Okay.
That's the overlapping.
Okay.
Then she dated Diddy. So she dated father and son.
Okay.
She dated father the son 1 year, the daddy the next year.
But then she spread it out a year before she dated the daddy.
Still nasty.
she gave a year break.
Then right after she dated Diddy, she dated Future from 2019 to 2020.
What's going on, only Michelle? See, appreciate you sliding through yesterday. Go ahead.
She dated Future from 2019 to 2020.
Okay.
Then she dated Michael B. Jordan, which was probably her longest relationship because she dated him for 2 years. So from 2020 to 2022, she dated Michael B. Jordan. Then she overlapped again. And dated the, what is his name? Damson Ingram?
Idris Elba of what the name? Snowfall?
Yeah, 2022
to
2023.
Okay.
That girl is a mess.
She dated, did she even give a break?
No.
Did she give her coochie a break? Like, she was just slamming dick in
there. From 2016 to 2023, she was just back to back.
She was just back to back slamming dick.
Yep.
Allegedly.
Yeah. Yeah.
Michelle's the only one. Michelle, she said that she date the Holy Ghost too.
Somewhere in there, probably before 2016.
Right.
Probably. Sheesh. Yeah, she definitely overlapped.
Hot coochie.
Overlaps.
Yeah, because it was definitely some time between she started when she announced the date. You know what I'm saying? Which they announced that they was dating, or it came out that they was dating from the time she broke up with the last person. Mm-hmm. So there had to be some overlap because you had to.
Yeah, she definitely overlapped.
Wow.
Definitely overlap.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah, and then we're going to go into... Now, I didn't even know this.
Uh-huh.
And I thought this man was reserved and, you know, cool, calm, and collected, laid back.
You got your food like Jeezy got your food.
Yeah, right? Like, I'm like, man, really? Common.
Oh, Oh, Carmen. No, he's from the Shy. We keep our stuff private.
Carmen dated Erykah Badu.
Bam.
Kerry Washington.
Uh huh.
Laura, I don't know her name. Duran.
Uh huh.
Taraji P. Henson.
Uh huh.
Serena Williams.
Woo.
Angela Ray.
Uh huh.
Tiffany Haddish.
Uh huh.
And is now currently dating Jennifer Hudson.
Okay.
I'm like, wow. I didn't even know all this. I never knew all of this.
And you're not supposed to know it.
Of course I'm not, but damn.
He going in the back. He going in the service entrance. He going to keep it low.
Then I was digging a little more, and I got to Future.
Oh, Lord. This going to end the goddamn show.
No.
No.
No, Future is, he
not what you think he is.
No, he not what you think he is.
He don't have hot dick.
The person that's going to end the show.
Oh, okay. Got hot.
Is Nick Cannon.
Oh, my God. Okay, well, what Future got going
on? So, Future dated India Jones, Jerrica, I don't know her last name, Jessica Smith, Tommy Lee, Brittany True, Josie Chavez, which, you know, Josie dated a few other people.
Okay.
She dated Bow Wow. She dated Future. She dated, I think she dated some other people. He dated Trina Lee, Ciara, Snow Bunny, Black China, Alexis Sky, Larsa Pippen, and Lori Harvey.
Jeez.
Y'all is doing a lot.
They celebrities. I mean.
Celebrity world. Y'all just think y'all can just date anybody.
They not dating. They fucking.
Dick them down. They just digging them
they
down.
They are not going for a long-term relationship, allegedly.
They is just digging them down. Just out here dicking them down.
And dicking them and cooching them up.
So your boy Didi, we gonna go back to him.
Okay.
He dated Missy Hilton, Kim Porter, Jennifer Lopez, Cameron Diaz, Naomi Campbell, Sarah, I don't know her last name, Emma Hemming,
uh-huh.
Sierra Miller, Cassie, Gina somebody, Lori Harvey,
uh-huh.
Dana Tran, and Young Miami.
Mm.
And it was a lot of overlapping in his dates, too. I just didn't write them down.
Those are just the ones we know about, right?
These are the ones we know about. Yes. These are the ones
allegedly,
we know about.
Allegedly, there's hundreds of others.
Allegedly, yes.
Allegedly. And what's going on, D?
I didn't know that Nelly had a roster, neither.
Okay. Yeah.
I didn't know this. I didn't know none of this stuff. See, I think I just be trying to, you know, see celebrities for who they are. Like, okay, they, you know.
You got to see them for fucking. Jesus Christ.
I wrote down the Kardashians list, but that's a.
Long list.
That's a.
You know who else got a long list that you probably don't have on that list?
Who?
Taylor Swift.
Lil Wayne.
Oh, I know Lil Wayne got long. Let me tell you something about Lil Wayne. I can respect him because he don't had it. And the women he date don't have it. You hear what's your name say? If he calls, she don't care if she in the bed with mm-hmm. her husband.
Yeah.
If he calls at 4 o'clock, 3 o'clock in the morning, she out of there.
Lil Wayne has a long list. Y'all, I'm scared to go down this Nick Cannon list.
Okay, let's go down it. We got 30 minutes.
Nicole Swishinger. Brandy Norwood.
Uh-huh.
Adrian Houghton.
Uh-huh.
Countess Vaughn. I never knew this.
Really?
Never knew this.
Okay.
Eva Marcel.
Uh-huh.
Christina Milian. Young.
Okay.
Kim Kardashian.
Okay.
Megan Good. Salida Ebanks.
Uh-huh.
Mariah Carey.
Uh-huh.
Rachel Smith. Brittany Bell.
Uh-huh.
I got Mariah on here twice. He must have double back.
He probably.
Jessica White.
Uh-huh.
Nicole Murphy.
Okay.
Charisse Conrell, something like that. Heidi Klum. Chili.
Heidi Klum.
Heidi Klum.
Heidi Klum.
A lot of these people I never knew about.
I definitely didn't know Heidi Klum. I like Heidi, too.
Yes, Chili.
She's down to earth. She's most one of the most down-to-earth models there is. Well, I can see because she seems like she's a fun person. Okay, keep going.
Chili from TLC.
Okay.
Gina Frums or something like that. Alicia Scott. Lanish Cole. Bree Treesome. And Addie. I don't know her last name. Uh-huh. Della Rosa. Addie Della Rosa.
Okay. And how many people on that list?
I have no idea.
Slick say, 11, 12, is it whores 14, 15, when 16, is it whoring when you 10, 20, fucking a famous person? Is it whores when you fucking a famous person? I'm gonna say, oh, is it whoring when you're fucking and famous? Yeah, just like it's still tricking if you got it.
But do they consider that whoring? Because when you famous, you never hear a lot of people, or famous people, be calling hoes. They like, you never hear people say, oh, they hoes, or you know, they just say, oh, they been with that person, and that person.
They hoes.
Now, they'll say Lori Harvey a hoe. They definitely say she's a hoe.
Man, all the motherfuckers be hoeing.
But allegedly, I never heard them say.
For real, allegedly.
Nick Cannon or Future, right. Or.
I they never always heard put them. That moniker on the women.
Yeah, I
they
never
don't
heard
that.
They
never put it on the men. The men be hoeing too.
Now, we definitely know them Kardashian is some hoes.
Allegedly.
Allegedly. No, not.
Allegedly. They got billions between them. We're going to say allegedly.
Oh, okay.
But we're going to think what we want to think.
Yeah, we definitely know they list is long.
Right.
But yeah, we definitely know they've been out there a lot.
I just... Yeah. I mean, I guess it's more of... If I can get it, am I going to turn it down? I guess that's what we have to think like.
Or is it to just say, oh, I've been with that person.
Or if the person's offering, if the person's offering, like if I was famous and I met Erykah Badu and she was like, come back and let's smoke some weed and burn some incense, I'm going to be thinking, I'm about to get this.
You going to burn some incense
with Erykah?
I'm about to
get this.
Erykah been naked too lately.
Hey, she knows she got that young boyfriend.
She been real naked lately.
She got
I
that like
20-something-year-old
boyfriend.
She been real naked lately.
Erykah was showing all her body. I wish I was 20-something. I could know her son. Take advantage
so
of me.
So silly.
Please.
Hey, Erykah stay around the block, too.
Hey, pull up.
Erykah definitely stays around the block.
Pull up. Tell you what this 53 feel like.
Not you trying to get with Erykah.
Man.
Erykah had you so much into the zen, you wouldn't even know.
I want to go there. Open the portal. I'm walking through.
If y'all did, you'd be like, did we fuck last night?
Yeah.
She'd be like.
That motherfucker be like, you want to join Illuminati? Yes.
She'd spit some game to you and you'd be like, okay, Erykah, I think so.
Yeah. I'll be going yes to everything. Yes.
And yes. Then Andre gonna come out the back with the flute.
I'll be like, yes, play us some mood music, homie. Play us some mood music.
Not you trying to get with Erykah. Not you trying to get with Miss Badu.
Man, please. Please.
Not
it'll be on and popping.
So yeah, now she got me puzzled. They don't call celebrities whores. Like they don't say it's horn.
Not for the men anyway.
No, but they do say it for females because I've heard a few times that, you know, Lori Harvey's been labeled one. Mm-hmm. Kim Kardashian, all the Kardashians.
Mm-hmm. Been labeled.
Including their mama, allegedly.
Right. Allegedly.
J-Lo, allegedly.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, so they don't label the men as that. Why not? Why is that a double standard? Like, why are females labeled whores but men are not?
Well... Because women, they prize possession is supposed to be hard to get, I guess. Men, you know, everybody say men just be out here having sex with anything. Women supposed to be very selective with who they choose to have sex with, from what I understand. But nowadays, coochie pink, booty hole brown, what?
Oh, my God.
What standard do we have nowadays? Like... It's so many people out here doing whatever they want to do. Do we really have a standard when it comes to sex and relationships anymore? Like, there's no standard.
So do you think it's because of the generation or the times we're living in? Things are changing? What?
I think it's all of that. I think it's the generation, the times we live in. And I think it's more prevalent now because of social media and all that. I think it was still the same thing back in the day.
Right.
Like, I think it was, like, I don't think anybody was really 100% faithful back in the day. Like... Mm-mm. Like, even if you married and all that stuff, it's just the fact that there was no social media to put that stuff forward.
I mean, it was social media, but it's not as big as it is now. Because y'all had MySpace and stuff like that back in the day, Black Planet.
Oh, no, I wasn't even on that.
But yeah, they had MySpace, Black Planet.
But it wasn't video friendly. Think about that, though. MySpace, Black Planet, all that wasn't video friendly. It was more picture based and phone call based. Mm-hmm. You get what I'm saying? Message based. It wasn't, you couldn't post a video. You couldn't really post a video until Vine when they had that, what, 1 minute video?
Yeah.
So, you, like, you couldn't back, even though you had the social medias with MySpace and Friendster and all that stuff, you couldn't post any videos back then.
Yeah.
So, that's the difference now. You could post videos and be like, I was with this person, or I was with that person, whatever the case
may be.
Everything
is about recording and camera. You can't. If you don't record it, it didn't happen.
They gonna make a jacket with a camera and video right in it. Right in it.
I sent that video where T.I. had got pulled over by the police. That man was like, "Nah, officer, you sitting out here trying to make it seem like I've been drinking and driving. I ain't been drinking and driving." I was like,
"Think about Tiffany Haddish. She just recently got pulled over for DUI.
She get pulled over all the time.
How people know? But see, that's what I'm saying. We know that if it wasn't for social media?
I don't think it was a social media. I think it was a dash cam. Because, you know, they have to release the dash cam.
Well, I saw a video of her walking, getting arrested and handcuffed from her car to the police car. That was a distance.
You know,
like
that's
somebody was across the street.
That's probably like TMZ or something. Because, you know, they always following celebrities.
Right. But I'm just saying, like,
but Tiffany,
I just think.
Tiffany always drunk, allegedly. She always.
I think she's going through something. You know, them celebrities go through things, man.
Yeah, of course they do. They human just like the rest of us.
Right.
So.
They just got more money to bullshit with and burn off.
And then I think the writer's strike had got to a lot of people too. So, you know, because they was out of work for all that time.
Yeah,
they wasn't working.
Yeah, I mean, they weren't the writers though. They were the celebrity. They was making more money than the writers.
Yeah, but I mean, you can't make no money without the writers.
Well, you gotta save them millions you had before it happened.
Because what's that one guy? It was one guy that said that, you know, since the writer's strike, he had to put up his house because he was getting low on funds. Like, and that's another thing. If you're a celebrity, why go and splurge on all the lavish stuff, never knowing what may happen? The what ifs.
Right.
Like, because anything can happen. Like the writer's strike.
Right.
They was out here.
Six says when you famous. When you famous, sex that you may not have been able to hit is reachable now. Sex that you may not have been able to get is reachable now.
Yeah, because you're famous. Everybody know you.
Right.
So sex don't come at the drop of a dime. And when you
weren't
famous.
I ain't gonna lie. If I was famous, like if I got famous now, like all of a sudden tomorrow I'm famous and they throwing panties at me, I'm running through these hoes. Yeah, my list gonna be long. You're gonna be like, damn, Lab, you got 18
That's
pages.
That's what she's saying. That's what she's saying.
When but I'm older
when
now.
When you're a celebrity, that'll happen.
I'm
won't even have to ask for it.
Somebody I'm gonna go back to all the hoes that told me no.
Somebody gonna throw their underwear and it's gonna be right there in reach for you.
I'm gonna go back to all the hoes that told me no in high school.
When I become famous, I'll be like, ugh. This peasant away from me. Now, who is this? Who is this guy?
Right.
Who? I don't know this guy.
Well, he says he's my child's father. I don't know him.
My kids have no father.
Right. My kids artificially inseminated.
Right.
That's cold-blooded.
Yeah. I don't know this guy.
That's cold. Let's say my kids have no father.
No.
That's funny.
Mm-mm. My kids have no father. I don't know him. He doesn't. Who? No. Sorry.
Yeah. That's a good one.
He met me when? What day? What time? Oh, no. I never lived there.
I wasn't even in that
Start
area
acting
this
real
time.
Brand new like, no, I don't know him. I drove his car. No.
He's stalking me.
Yeah.
He's stalking me.
I'm going to, yeah.
You want them restraining orders against your...
Restraining order?
Against your baby daddy,
mm-hmm.
who used to live with you. Mm-hmm. Y'all used to live together, because he's famous now. I don't know him. Hell, you talking about?
I'd be
about?
Like, get him and his mother. Because I ain't like her ass neither. Look, who's this old lady?
You had him arrested. You come home one day, like, oh, there's strangers in my house.
Yeah. Like, please get him and his mother.
Right, there's strangers in my house.
I don't know this lady.
The police be like, but ma'am, he has underwear for his stuff folded in the drawer. Oh, my God.
Right.
He's
like,
brought underwear here, too.
Just be real brand new for no reason.
Right.
No. Mm-mm. Because the way they treated me, yes, that would be payback.
Right.
I would be petty at an all-time high.
You yes. got to be, I mean, think about it. You just got, like, if I was famous earlier, it probably wouldn't be the case. But now that I'm older, and then, like, tomorrow, and I got famous, like, overnight, like, and they was like, you famous now? And I was like, oh, shit.
It's over.
And all of a sudden, my followers went up to millions.
It's over.
It's over. And then Instagram just gave me a blue check out the blue for it's free. It's over. Shit.
I'll start going down my followers list and be like, unfollow, right. Unfollow. Oh, you never supported me? Unfollow.
But, yeah. They would be like, and me and Slick talk about this. I got rich.
Oh, yeah.
Like, fuck you money, like, money, they wouldn't be able to deal with me. I would be such a fucking asshole.
I just asked my significant other that. I said, what if we hit the lottery? And I said, would you pay them to keep your name quiet, or would you go in front of the world and say, hey, I won? He said, they wouldn't know nothing.
Mm-hmm.
I said, yeah, because you know how many people would be like, hey, I met you. We used to kick it around the block. We used to... I'd be like, get away.
Right.
Like, no, get away. Who is you? I don't have anything for you. Who are you?
But you know that they making it, they suing them to keep your name quiet. I don't know if I want to keep my name quiet, because I wouldn't be able to get the revenge I want to get.
Or you want people to know?
Oh, I'm talking about asshole.
You want people to know you got money?
Because they wouldn't be able to get it from me.
I wouldn't care.
They won't be able to get it from, because the way I have my shit set up, it'd have to be four people to check, and then Slick could be the checking on the last checking, because she squeezes a dime.
You don't want to mess with Slick. You do not want to mess with her.
But I'd be an asshole. I know I would be.
I don't think I'd be an asshole. I think my whole perspective would change. Like, I'd be like, no, I'm good.
Right.
No, don't call me. No, I don't want to hang out.
Remember when I was broke and how you didn't dial my number?
No, I don't want to hang out.
Let's keep that same energy.
Yeah, no. No, I don't want to be invited to your Christmas party.
Because they be expecting gifts and shit.
Yeah.
Like, yo, they rich. Guess how many parties do you think you'll get invited to?
A lot. Everything.
Right.
Everything in Atlanta. Everything. Right. Oh, invite her. She got money. Right. Nope, I ain't got none.
All the parties that all your coworkers who didn't invite you to anything, all of a sudden remember your number.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Hey, girl, we having an ugly sweater. Nope, I don't like ugly stuff. Nope.
Yeah.
Nope. Hey, girl, my birthday party coming around. I don't celebrate birthdays.
That would be amazing, because you know motherfuckers would do that.
Mm-hmm. Of course they would. Of course they would. That's why I always tell people, support people now while they don't have nothing, when they down, because you're going to eventually need them same people.
Right.
You're going to eventually need them same people. I try to support everybody.
Right.
Because I never know who I might need later on down the line.
People, man. People amaze me. People amaze me. Like, the older I get, the more I hate these motherfuckers.
She said,
man,
you know I'm a sweet pie. Sweetest pie.
The older I get, the more I hate these motherfuckers, man. Like,
yeah. People are really starting to be annoying, starting to get on my nerves. And I still have to write my list of people that can't go on to 2024 with us.
Oh.
That we are leaving.
My list is so long, I thought I might have to cut it back.
I don't want to cut
mine
back.
I was looking at my list today, I was like, sheesh.
Yeah.
I hate everybody.
Right. Right. There is plenty of people on that list that should not enter into 2024.
Not that we wishing bad on them.
No, we don't wish bad on them. We just don't want to hear about them.
Right.
I'm getting tired of every week talking about Boosie. I just seen the video with him cussing people out, talking about something. He need more time.
More time for what?
He was at a rap. He was at some kind of concert, and they were trying to cut him short.
Right.
And he was like, I'm Boosie. I need more time. Nobody cares.
What's the last song you had?
Wipe me down. Wipe me down. Wipe me down.
Right.
Who cares?
Right.
I'm sick of him. I'm sick of... Now King has been added to this list.
Because
King is annoying.
We're going to say the list. Let's not. Y'all got to tune back in for the K Come to 2024
yes.
list. And what day we going to do that?
We have 30 days until the new year.
Yes.
30 days.
Yes. So that's a lot of people. We could write down 5 people a day.
Yes.
Yes. And five things. We are not just people, but things, attitudes, sayings, clothing.
We're going to both write down our top 20.
Yes.
Our top 20.
Right. We're going to come up with categories.
Yes.
And write down the top 20 in each category. We're going to have five categories, I think. That's 100 things, ain't it? I could easily have 100 people list.
That's a two-day show. Okay, that's okay. Like, that's a lot of people.
Okay, we're going to do our top 20 in all categories under one.
Yeah.
How about
why,
that?
Why we want them to stay here in 2023.
Right.
But, yeah, please don't get on my nerves in 2024. Please. Because I'm sick of y'all.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm very, very sick of y'all.
We got to get it together as people.
She said this year was a blur. This year definitely was a blur.
It went by fast.
This year definitely has showed me some stuff. This year was hell. But, hey, it went by. It definitely went by fast.
It went by real fast. Like.
And them punk-ass supervisors that I work for this year... Y'all.
Y'all not coming to 2024. Y'all gonna be at the top of the list.
Yes. So, yeah, this year definitely went by fast. Yes. And then next year, a leap year.
Oh. So we go ahead 4 years? How many years is a leap year? Just one?
I think it's every 4 years.
So it's February 28th.
29th.
So we had one more day.
Yeah.
So what if... I would talk about that now.
Well, somebody was born on that day.
I actually
have a god brother that was born on leap year.
On 29th.
On the 29th.
So he's always celebrates on 28th.
Yeah, 28th. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So, yeah, that's crazy. But I think he's supposed 12. To be like 10.
Right. I'm only 12, man. What you talking about?
Yeah, because it come around what every 10 years
every
or
4 years.
Every 4 years.
Yeah.
Yeah. So he not that old, but. For real. He not that old, but...
In years,
in
he's not...
In leap years, right. He not that old, but yeah. Yeah.
All right.
But yeah, we definitely gonna write down this list, and we're definitely gonna have it together.
Mm-hmm.
And we definitely gonna circle back to some of the topics that we missed tonight.
We're gonna come back to them next week, and we're gonna talk about them in depth a little bit. We might, of course, by then... It's going to be something else.
Yeah, because y'all doing dumb shit every day.
Every day.
Every day.
Some dumb shit happen. There might be some dumb shit going on right now.
For us to talk about. So, we definitely will be back, and we will see you all next week. Bye.
Go live with them.
I don't know.
Always in the middle of the show, they always be trying to go live.